A very good morning to one and all. Welcome to the Yong Pung Hao School of Law Commencement Ceremony. My name is Andrea, and I am the Master of Ceremonies for today. Graduation, for all of us, is a time for much celebration and fanfare. So, without further ado, please rise and give a round of applause to welcome our distinguished faculty members. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem. Thank you, and please take your seats. Thank you, everyone, for being here today to witness and celebrate the achievements of our graduates. Despite the pandemic, I am grateful that we are able to gather and commemorate this milestone. The commencement opening ceremony for the class of 2021 took place earlier on 7 January, where SMU senior faculty declared the start of the ceremonies for this class. Let us take a look at the highlights.
On behalf of Singapore Management University, I am pleased to extend my warmest welcome to our distinguished guests, faculty, graduates, and family members. I hereby declare Commencement 2021 ceremonies open.
Completing your programs, taking exams, and seeking to commence your careers during a period of unprecedented disruption tested the resilience, resourcefulness, and creativity that SMU had sought to develop in you. We believe in you, wish you all the very best, and know you will continue to fly the SMU flag high and with honor.
Through it all, I strongly encourage all of you to keep on learning. Today is your graduation, but it's just the beginning of a journey of lifelong learning, and that's why we call it a commencement. Importantly, as you continue to learn and grow, don't forget those who have nurtured you throughout the years. Don't forget your community. Take time to give back to your neighborhood and look out for those who are more vulnerable around you.
I just want to say that I'm glad to see so many of you again and to know that you are safe, well, and adapting to this new normal. I hope to be able to see you again soon, perhaps when you attend our alumni events, take up a postgraduate course, or volunteer to mentor your juniors. We look forward to you staying in touch with your alma mater.
It is my pleasure to invite our Dean, Professor Goh Yihan, to make a speech. Prof. Goh, please.
Distinguished guests, colleagues, graduates of the class of 2021, together with your family and friends. I'm truly delighted to see all of you in person today. After all the ups and downs, twists and turns, we are finally here. A crowd-controlled physical ceremony where everyone is masked, but a physical ceremony no less. Let me begin by extending my warmest congratulations to each and every graduate today. Through resilience, diligence, and faith, you have all graduated from law school. That itself is a tremendous achievement, but to do it amidst the pandemic makes it even more special indeed. It is also on this day that we celebrate those who made all of this possible for our graduates. Parents, friends, and spouses. All of you are the pillars of support that have enabled each of our graduates' success today. And for that, we thank you. As I went about writing this speech, it occurred to me that I share a special connection with the class of 2021. You see, just as I started my term as dean in July 2017, so too did most of the class of 2021 start your law school journey about a month later at Camp Dissidium. And now, just as I'm ending my term as dean in June this year, so too are you, the class of 2021, ending your law school journey with commencement this year. It is an understatement to say that much has happened since 2017. For a start, even the name of our law school has changed to the Yong Pung Hao School of Law. We are amidst a pandemic. It is now mandatory for us to wear masks when we are outside. It is now common to have classes and meetings over Zoom. But beyond all of this, I've had the immense privilege of witnessing the growth of the class of 2021, not only in your capability in the law, but also in the maturation of your character. And so as I thought about what to speak about this morning, I figured I could share perhaps three lessons that I learned in my time as dean, without intending, of course, for this to be any way a self-indulgent speech. The first lesson I learned is to be humble. Be humble because there will be many things that we do not know about. But being humble also means that it is all right to be afraid of the commencement of a task or a milestone in your life, just as you are now stepping out into the working world. I remember stepping into the Dean's office for the first time as Dean on 1st July 2017. As I sat down on my desk, the enormity of the role dawned upon me. I had documents from the university departments I never knew existed, needing my signature. I had multiple unread emails from people I did not know in my inbox. I was truly afraid about what lied ahead, but I think that concern in turn spurred me not only to try harder, but to seek help. It is all right to be fearful of what lies ahead. Being afraid in these circumstances is not a sign of weakness, but a recognition of the difficulties and a desire to overcome them. But let it not be crippling fear where you end up doing nothing. Let it be fear that comes out of humility, one that spurs you to seek counsel and to do better. The second lesson I learned is to be bold. Former US President Barack Obama famously spoke about the audacity of hope, about how we should reject cynicism and embrace dreams. As a young law school, we have had to constantly dream beyond what we have at present. But it is in dreams that progress is made and barriers are broken. Indeed, one of our proudest moments is securing large research grants in law and technology in the last 5 years. It is not so much about the money, but that in securing these grants, we edged out larger law schools and proved to ourselves that we can do it, so long as we dare to dream and work cohesively together. And so I implore you, as you enter the next phase of your lives, to never stop aiming for the stars. Do not fear failure, because if you miss the stars, you may still end up amongst the planets, and that's better than remaining on planet Earth. People may laugh at you, but take it in your stride as you retain that childlike faith to believe that all things are possible, if not today, then someday. For it has been said, dream big, for you can't stuff a great life into a small dream. The third lesson, then, is to have faith. As lawyers, we tend to rely much on reason, that with the data we have and extrapolating forward, we reason that things should happen, should end up in a certain way. Sometimes that data can lead us to conclude that things would not work. Coming back to my first few days as dean, as I struggled with documents from university departments that I now know better exist, I took a walk along Fort Canning in what must have been a slight drizzle. And there, above the Kwa Geok Siu Law Library, was a full arc of rainbow. I stopped, took 30 photos of it, and then admired it. It was an encouragement to me that everything will be fine. Have faith that everything will work out well for you in the end, even if it's not in a way you had imagined it to be from the start. Have faith, despite what people may tell you, whether ill-intentioned or not. And have faith, even when things seem the most difficult, because you do not know what lies ahead, just beyond that seemingly insurmountable hurdle. Be humble, be bold, and have faith. These are the three lessons I've learned as a young, inexperienced dean who has had the benefit of immense kindness and support over the years. And these lessons can be summed up by a quote I saw online. "It's impossible," said pride. "It's risky," said experience. "It's pointless," said reason. "But give it a try," whispered the heart. Listen to that whisper in your heart as you commence the next stage of your lives, and never underestimate the power that lies within you. Ultimately, above being humble, bold, and having faith, be kind. As I look back at the last 5 years, what I remember the most is not the tangible achievements we have made collectively as a school, but the people, students, and colleagues whom I've had the blessing of knowing. You never know how your kindness can lift the spirits of another human being. Indeed, I remember that on the first day of my term, our former dean, Professor Yeo Tiong Min, left a kind note for me. It said, amongst other things, he will always be around to help. I also remember, during my birthday on my first year as dean, our colleagues at the GO surprised me with an elaborate cake depicting the solar system. These kind gestures brought much-needed encouragement. And indeed, as a Bloomberg article delightfully states, mean is easy, kind is hard. Those with greater ambitions should leave such casual cruelty behind them. Be kind, and be kind especially to those who may never be in the position to help you. In closing, I would like to sound a personal note, if I may. This will be the last commencement speech I will be giving as Dean. I want to say to the students, faculty, and staff today that being Dean has been one of the greatest privileges of my life. There are aspects of the job I will miss, and others that I'll be very happy to say farewell to, but it has been the people who has made the last 5 years so rewarding and fruitful. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. We have come some way from virtual Zoom ceremonies to this socially distant but physical ceremony. Whilst the physical manifestation of your learnings is now represented by a physical scroll at a physical ceremony, I hope you will agree with me that the essence of being a lawyer lies not in a scroll, but in your heart to right injustice in the world and to do the right thing by being humble, being bold, and having faith. Allow me to once again congratulate all of you on your graduation. We await with eager anticipation the difference that each of you will be making. But please remember your alma mater, and we hope you will stay in touch as our alumni. Indeed, once you are part of the SMU family, you never really can leave. Go on and make this a better world for the next generation. That will be your measure and the measure of this school. Have a wonderful commencement. Congratulations once again, and thank you so very much.
Thank you, Dean, for the inspiring speech. And please remain on stage. We will now begin with the presentation of the degrees.
Aditya Bhattacharya, Aidan Goh Kuo Yao, Ao Wei An Winnie, cum laude. Arushi Bhatnagar, magna cum laude. Ashley Lo Lien, cum laude. Athelia Ong Kaiti, Ao Yi Ting Caroline, cum laude. Brenda Ku Yu Ting. Emeric Xia Qian Ming, summa cum laude. Benedict Ko Yen Hin, magna cum laude. Brandon Lai Hong Sheng. Caleb Sid Hien Ren, Magna Cum Laude, Clyde & Co, Classic Singapore Prize top for the top student in insurance law. Kerry Leong Anting. Chai Wen Min, summa cum laude. Chan Jia Fen, magna cum laude. Carissa Tan. Chao Wing Wei, cum laude. Chia Jong Yong Mark, magna cum laude, winner of the Asian Patents Tennis Association Prize for top student, international commercialization of IP. Chong Kai Yi Crystal. Christy Ann Wee Shiti. Chua Ching Wei, magna cum laude. Chong Jun Hui Joel, cum laude. Chai Shu Li, summa cum laude. Claire Tan Su Yin, cum laude. Claire Marie Chan Manling, cum laude. Dexter Chu Yun Zhang, magna cum laude. Do Han. Emma Elizabeth Tang Seng Yi. Erica Rachel Chiang Sin Rong, magna cum laude. Faith Magdalena Kwek, cum laude. Farana Alam. Felicia T. Sinyi. Fu Jialing Grace, magna cum laude. Fu Wanying Wendy, cum laude. Gabriel Au, cum laude. Gerald Lo Hong Lee, magna cum laude. Gita Priska Adelia, cum laude. Gladys Lim Hin Teng, summa cum laude, winner of the TSMP Law Corporation Prize for the best law student in ethics and social responsibility. Grace Ho Jiahui. Hugh Zhan Zi, magna cum laude. Ho Yen Kai Petro, magna cum laude. Hong Wei Hao Randy, cum laude, winner of the Bird and Bird Prize for the top student in IT and the law. Hudson Wong, magna cum laude. Irina Xia Shueqi, magna cum laude. Irvin Ho Jia Xian, summa cum laude and winner of the TSMP Law Corporation Prize for the best law student in ethics and social responsibility. Jamie Lo. Jiang Xin Xuan Jennings, cum laude. Lao Yihan, summa cum laude and winner of the SMU Circle Award. Leandra Shannon Nye. Li Chong Jie, cum laude. Li Wei Ting, cum laude. Leon Sim Jun An, magna cum laude. Li Zhi Zheng, summa cum laude. Lim Mei Xian Christine, cum laude. Linda Shi Pei Feng, magna cum laude. Lo Guan Ling Queenie, magna cum laude. Lo Jia Na, summa cum laude and winner of the Joe Greenberg Top Advocate Prize for Best Student in International Moot 1. Lu Yan Rong Alicia. Lashla Nina Gautier, summa cum laude, winner of the Portcullis Trust Prize for the top student in Law of Equity and Trusts. Manvinda Kwa Seti, daughter of Sawan Singh. Marcus Chia Hao Jun, cum laude. Mark Chia Zihan, cum laude. Mary Tan Sin Wei, cum laude. Michelle Cheong Shi Yun. Muhammad Ali Azira. Muhammad Shafi bin Alamin, cum laude. Naomi Lim Bao Bao, magna cum laude, winner of the Amajit Singh Senior Counsel Law Prize for Public International Law. Nathaniel Carmelo Lopez, cum laude. Naukaniel Will. Ni Hung Yi Adriel. Caleb V. Song Un. Kit Ng Xin Ying, cum laude. Aiden Go Guo Yao, magna cum laude. Ladies and gentlemen, this year we are proud to present the Kwek Hong Pung Valedictorian Award and SPH Valedictorian Award to Darian De Chun Yu, summa cum laude, joint winner of the Portcullis Trust Prize for the top student in Law of Equity and Trusts, winner of SMU Yongfang Hao School of Law Best GPA Award.
Thank you, Prof. Goh. May we invite you back to your seat, please. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the screens from the speech from the Kwek Hong Pung and SMU Yongbang Hao School of Law Valedictorian, Sujin Chandran.
Dear Dean, faculty members, guests, and fellow graduates, my name is Sujin Chandran, and I'm honored to be representing the Yongbang Hao School of Law as the valedictorian this year. Thank you for gathering here today. First and foremost, I want to give thanks to my family, professors, mentors, friends and partner for your support and presence in my life. You know who you are and you know how much I value you. Right now, many of us have taken the first step in our careers. As the great philosopher and basketballer Troy Bolton once said, it's the start of something new. So, let's think back to the start of our SMU journey for a moment. Remember how you felt when you were cold-called in class for the first time? Or the existential dread we experienced each time we put away our laptops for contract law 2 classes? And of course, we remember all too well the fear of messing up something big in an exam. I'm sure these familiar feelings of fear and anxiety will re-emerge as we tackle life's new challenges. But you know what? We are here not as quitters, but as survivors. We've embraced the rigors of life, and instead of crumbling, we emerge as proud graduates of SMU Law. And the important people in our lives have supported us through it all. So, as we take the next step, we can trust that we'll work this out and that we are all in this together. We can also remember that we have much to be collectively proud of as a batch. Some of our peers serve as members of the bar, fighting tirelessly for our rights and welfare. Others build creative legal tech solutions like the reading list downloader. Some incredibly intelligent peers have published insightful academic articles. And some have experimented with starting awesome businesses like a K-pop marketplace. Others have launched humanitarian initiatives like making welfare packs for the less fortunate or helping refugees overseas. And above all, I'm sure that every one of us has been a shoulder to lean on in someone else's time of need. To me, that is as meaningful an achievement as any other. As a wise man once said, greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. All of this makes me really proud of us. Thank you for being a part of my SMU experience. Back to the present moment, many of us have heard anecdotes about the professional and interpersonal struggles lawyers face and are probably somewhat resigned to our fates. Nevertheless, I want to encourage us to dare to be different, to take responsibility for the culture wherever we end up, and to strive to be that salt and light who edifies others and enables them to flourish. Imagine the collective power we have as a generation of SMU grads to be a transformative force in society, fighting fiercely not only for the good of our clients, but for the utmost good of everyone in our lives. Perhaps my dream is somewhat naive in a competitive eat-what-you-kill world, but I dream this having seen how supportive and encouraging my batchmates can be. And perhaps it is up to us to define success for ourselves. But I invite us to look beyond the ephemeral and define success in terms of our fundamental purpose. Allow me to close with some advice given by a lawyer to one of my peers. Receive criticism humbly, pause to learn from your mistakes, and keep moving forward. Above all, always be kind, compassionate, and fair, even if you don't receive the same. Remember that you are a lawyer, but first and foremost, a human being too. Once again, my heartiest congratulations to everyone. Let us continue being a generation that makes a difference.
Thank you, Sujin. And now for the finale. This special dance performance is choreographed and performed by our very own SMU Hip Hop Dance Club, SMU Eurythmics. It celebrates the achievements of our graduates, at the same time depicts their resilience and the confidence that they'll emerge stronger from the pandemic. Please sit back and enjoy.
Gorilla in the fucking coop, finna pull up in the zoo. I'm like, Chief, keep me Rafiki, who been lying king to you? Pocket watch it like kangaroos, tell these clowns we ain't amused. Man, the clips for that monkey business, 4-5 got changed for you. Motorcades when it came to presidential with the planes too. One better get you with the presidential, undefeated with the cane too. I said no to the super bowl, you need me, I don't need you. Every night we in the end zone, tell the NFL we get stadium. Tell the Grammys that over H. Have you ever seen a crowd going ape shit?
Graduates, today marks the beginning of a new journey in your lives, and I hope that we will do each other proud in the years ahead. You have now graduated from SMU. With those parting words, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of the ceremony. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain seated as our dean and faculty take their leave. May we invite Dean Goh to lead the recessional. Graduates, please follow our usher's directives to exit the hall. Parents, please remain in your seats. Our ushers will direct your zones out of the hall one at a time. In the meantime, please share your feedback with us via the QR code up from the screen or from the Commencement website. Thank you, and please continue to stay safe.